Okay, this is going to be the second video about solving absolute value equations and inequalities. And I want to pick up where I left off with the first video and go on to inequalities. So here's what we had from the first video, but I've changed one thing. Instead of saying the absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3, I've changed the problem to the absolute value of x minus 2 is greater than 3. Now the graph is going to look exactly the same. In other words, I'm going to have y sub 1 equals the absolute value of x minus 2. That was the left side of my inequality. And y sub 2 equals 3 because the right side of my inequality was a 3. And now I'm going to look at the graph. I guess I should change this part here to also greater than. And let's understand what we're looking for. We're looking for something which is greater than 3. Well, I've got this horizontal line here where y equals 3. That's the 3 we're talking about. Any place where y equaled 4 or 5 or 6 would be greater than y equals 3. So let me continue my graph upward a little bit. I would have a 4 and a 5. And all the places above that green y equals 3 line would be places where y has a greater value than 3. And now I want to find out where the absolute value part of the equation, the absolute value of x minus 2, was greater than 3. In other words, where is the absolute value of my graph greater than the y equals 3 line? Well, basically, it's going to be the places where the graph is above that line. Now, I know that they meet when x is negative 1. Any place to the left of that point where they meet at negative 1, 3, my red line, my absolute value v, is higher than my y equals 3 line. So all these places where my red line is higher, where my absolute value has a greater value than 3, are going to be parts of my answer. So everywhere from negative infinity all the way up to 3 will mean that that x is a valid answer. Okay, let's write that in and make sure this makes sense. So what I know is that x has to be less than negative 1. Now let's pick a number less than negative 1 and make sure that works. So what if I say x equals negative 7? Okay, well, if I go back to the original equation, I'm going to have the absolute value of negative 7 minus 2 is greater than 3. Well, negative 7 minus 2 is negative 9, but the absolute value of negative 9 is 9, and 9 is definitely greater than 3. So any number that's less than negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative infinity, is going to work in this inequality. Now, there's going to be another place I have to look. I have to look over past this point where the ordered pair is 5, 3. Because over there, my absolute value v is the left side of the inequality, is also higher than the y equals 3 line. So any place where x is greater than 5 is also going to be a valid answer. So I'm going to put that in. X is greater than 5. And let's try that out and make sure it works. So let's say I put in a positive 7. Well, 7 minus 2 is 5. The absolute value of 5 is 5, and 5 is greater than 3. Okay? So the answer is going to be x is less than negative 1, or x is greater than 5. I can graph that on a number line, basically the same thing as the x-axis that I've got here. And I'm going to have an open circle at negative 1. And then I know that everything to the left going down towards negative infinity is going to be part of my answer. And I can go over to the place on my number line that would be the same as 5, put in an open circle, draw my arrow to the right because every place greater than 5 is also going to be part of my answer. And if I'm told to write this in interval notation, I'm going to write something like, I use rounded parentheses, negative infinity to negative 1, and rounded parentheses again, since it was less than, but it wasn't equal to, I'll use that U for union, meaning I can also have from 5 with rounded parentheses and going up to infinity. Okay? So three ways to write this, either as a compound inequality, as the answer on a number line, or in interval notation. Now, you might have also had the absolute value of x minus 2 is less than 3. We're going to use the same procedure for solving that. Let me just get rid of my answers. I'm going to find the intersection points, but now what I want to know is where are the y values for my absolute value v less than the y values for y sub 2 equals 3? In other words, when are they less than 3? Since I'm trying to find when the absolute value of x minus 2 equals 3. Well, the place where they're less than 3 are all these places on the graph where the v is below that horizontal y sub 2 equals 3 line. So those are all the places between x equals negative 1 and x equals 5. So my answer is going to be x is greater than negative 1 and x is less than 5. And we can check that. Let's pick some number which is greater than 1 and less than 5. Or a really easy number would be 0. 0 is greater than negative 1 and it's less than 5. So if I plug 0 into this original problem, 0 minus 2 is negative 2. The absolute value of negative 2 is 2, and 2 is less than 3. Let's take a slightly higher number. Let's use 4 just to make sure this works for everything in between those two points. So if I put 4 in here, 4 minus 2 is 2. The absolute value of 2 is 2, and 2 is less than 3. Okay, so this is my answer. X is greater than negative 1, and x is less than 5. Putting that onto a number line, I'm going to once again have an open circle at negative 1, and I'll have an open circle at x equals 5. But it was a compound inequality, and I want all the places between those two open circles. Writing it as interval notation, I'm going to have negative 1 is less than x is less than 5. Okay? So I hope this made sense. I hope it helped. Do a bit of practice with this to make sure you're comfortable with it. Take care. I'll see you next time.